We are in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Chef Joe Simone is here. Yes, he is back. Simone's is the restaurant. Tomato, rosemary risotto, pork, and braised leeks.
Very good. Well,
that's what it is. All right, now everyone remembers you from Sunnyside when you had Sunnyside.
Yep.
Simone's is going to be your new place, right?
Yep, our new restaurant, still in Warren, serving breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Right.
And why is the name Simone's? Because it really is a family affair.
Good. That's good. And you and I were talking about how you just love the people who come in to your restaurant because
we've been closed for about a year and a half.
Right, and they're still seeking you out.
Definitely. Every day we get emails and phone calls from people looking forward to when we're going to reopen.
Well, I know. You've made breakfast here before, and it's really, really good. And you're expanding. You get other things on the menu.
Yep.
Talk to us about what we're making today.
Okay, so we're going to make a risotto, and we're going to top it with a very simple stew. Mm-hmm. The ingredients for the risotto are, of course, arborio rice, onions, fresh rosemary chopped really fine, butter, Parmesan cheese, and a little bit of vegetable stock, which is over there. The ingredients for, crushed tomato for the risotto also.
Okay.
For the stew is going to be braised leeks, and this is a pork shoulder that I cooked yesterday for 5 hours in my oven, and then I just picked it apart, and these are some of the drippings from the pork.
So by 5 hours, it probably just fell apart.
Yeah, totally fell apart. But you don't have to do anything. You just set the oven low, cover it with foil, and let it go.
And let it go. Okay, yep. So this is something anyone can make tonight. Very easy to do. Talk to us about the new place.
New restaurant, open for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Okay.
It's on Child Street in Warren. Mm-hmm. We bought an existing restaurant. We're doing a thorough renovation.
Yeah.
And it's just taking us a lot longer than we thought.
As you call it, it's an exorcism.
Yes. Yes, we did. It performed an exorcism. And we have a dear friend, her name is Deirdre, who's coming to smudge the place too.
Perfect.
I'll do anything to get this place open.
Now, I know in the time that you had Sunnyside, you didn't have a restaurant per se, but you're a busy guy.
Yeah.
You're all over the place, and you're still cooking, and you're still working it.
Cooking.
And trying to get the new place all set
exactly.
And ready to go. Good?
Exactly.
All right. Well, this looks great. It's going to be easy for you to make tonight, whip up tonight, get this done, special dinner. We are going to start to put everything together in just a little bit. We're glad Joe's here, and we are going to get to it coming up.
Yeah, that's right. Renner, we're back here with Chef Joe Simone from Simone's. Fitting name. How long did it take you to figure that out?
Well, you know, since my brother is going to be our manager, it really is a family affair.
Hey, there you go.
That's how it came around.
Bringing the whole family together.
Yeah.
We're making risotto, something that is takes up some time.
It's intimidating to a lot of people if you've never done it.
Yeah.
So let me tell you that we've done a couple of steps right now, but if you notice how it's very, like, you can kind of see steam rising off it. Mm-hmm. We're cooking it very slowly.
Okay.
The most important thing about risotto is that your stock is hot.
Because
when you go to add
it,
this is vegetable stock.
Okay.
But you can use chicken stock or whatever you want.
Yeah.
And if you have nothing, use hot water. Because you're going to put cheese and butter and other stuff in it too.
It'll flavor it up.
Okay? That's right. So what I did was I sauteed some onion and olive oil.
Mm-hmm.
Then I put the rice in, okay? Special arborio rice or whatever rice is suitable for risotto.
Mm-hmm.
Cooked it over high heat until you could sort of smell the rice toasting.
Okay.
Then I added about 3 ladles of hot stock in here, and I instantly turned the heat down to very low.
Mm-hmm.
What this means,
seasonings in there too.
I have rosemary, excuse me.
Okay.
Yeah, I have some fresh rosemary. Notice how finely it's chopped up.
I almost didn't recognize it. That's why I had to ask, because usually...
In my mind, if you chop it not fine enough,
mm-hmm.
it tastes like pine needles in your teeth.
Oh,
do you know what I mean?
No, I
like it really fine. So what we're doing is, notice I'm not stirring it. There's no stress going on right now. Because people think that you have to stir it all the time. If you are cooking it very quickly,
mm-hmm.
yes, you do. But if you take your time, take about 20 minutes, you can cook it slowly, and then every once in a while, you add a little more stock.
How do you know when it's time to add in more stock?
When it looks like the stock is almost all the way absorbed.
Okay, it's just going to take that long to absorb. So eyeball it. Let it sit there for a little while.
Yep.
And then that will be almost our base, right? You said
mm-hmm.
that we're going to top it with another mixture?
Yeah, what we're going to do is I have in here some of the leeks that
mm-hmm.
I cooked yesterday and some pork shoulder that I cooked and
Beautiful.
Pulled. And I'm going to serve it with that on top.
Okay, great. The arborio rice is going. We're going to keep adding some stock to it, and we will finish this up when we come back.
We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. One of our favorite guys, Chef Joe Simone, is here from Simone's Tomato Rosemary Risotto.
He's stirring. Everybody's busy.
So we've been cooking this, adding stock as we needed to.
Mm-hmm.
I added the crushed tomatoes, and right when the camera turned back on, I was... mixing some butter in here.
Yes.
Now, will you pour some cheese on top of here?
What kind of cheese we got?
This
going
is grated
on?
Parmesan Reggiano.
Yum.
More.
Something that's great about risotto.
Dump the whole thing. Why not? Right.
It's thick. It's creamy. It's very hearty.
Yep. And that flavor. It's just unmistakable.
So this is one of the deals. You got to keep stirring this risotto here too.
Yeah, but we're about ready.
Okay.
We're
going to
be serving it up in about 1 second.
Good. All right. Can you just take it up to speed on what we've put in here and what we've done so far, just so everyone knows?
Okay. So we wilted onion and olive oil.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We added chopped rosemary.
Okay.
And the rice. We toasted the rice. Then we added stock and turned the heat way down.
All right.
We let it cook very slowly so we didn't have to worry about stirring it all the time.
Yes.
Added stock as the rice absorbed it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Added crushed tomatoes. And then butter and Parmesan cheese.
Okay.
Okay.
Sounds good to me.
And you test for salt, but I know it's going to be perfect. Okay?
You've made this enough.
You made
you know.
It.
Well,
you know the deal.
No, I cannot lie. I tasted it right before the camera got turned on.
You can't tell everybody that. Boy,
just say yes, I'm
fantastic.
A culinary genius.
No, I can't claim to be like that. You know, you can call me a lot of things, but a salt savant I am not. Okay, so in here are the leeks and the pork shoulder.
It smells phenomenal.
Yeah, with just a little bit of the stock that we put in the risotto.
Mm-hmm.
And some of the pork drippings.
And the pork shoulder you said you had, you were cooking that for 5 hours.
5 hours.
And then kind of pulled it apart.
Wow. Ooh,
and then
pulled
it apart.
Bite. And then, I cooked it yesterday for 5 hours because I had a big piece of pork.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I just checked it every like hour or half an hour until it pulled apart easily.
Yep.
It was like almost melting.
Great, great flavors coming
together
good? There. Yes, and I think this is something too that you
Thanks,
could
sir.
Really
You're welcome.
Rework and reuse like your leftovers. Because
totally.
If you made that some of that the
Say
night before.
Say you made a pork roast for dinner and you had it left over.
Right.
Right? Then the next day you just whip these up. If you don't want to make the leeks, don't make the leeks. And if you want, you could put the pork right inside of here.
Mm. Yum.
Okay.
Yeah, and let that all kind of get
good.
Into one
really
dish.
Good, Joe.
Good.
Perfect.
I think this
salt
is the first thing that's non-breakfast
it is.
That I've ever cooked for you guys.
That's actually true.
And that's a good thing. At Simone's, at your new place, when you open, what are you going to have to offer? Will this
We're going to serve dinner and breakfast and lunch.
You're okay.
The dinner menu is going to be Italian-inspired and being very sensitive to where we're located here in Rhode Island, if that makes sense.
Very nice. And talk about the location.
275 Child Street in Warren.
So it's a great location.
You mentioned that a lot of people, I'm sure if they've been going by, they've been seeing a lot of work being done.
We are just awestruck by our awesome guests and members of our community.
They've been coming in.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, so prepping for a new restaurant, what is that like? You had the restaurant before, which was Sunnyside.
Yeah.
We did a lot of breakfast stuff.
Yeah.
So now this is a whole new ball game for you, and you've been busy in between anyway.
Yeah, and before I had my breakfast restaurant, I worked in dinner restaurants for a very long time.
Right.
So the interesting thing to me with this restaurant is to sort of take dinner and all the equipment and all of the, you know, the accoutrements that you know, a good dinner restaurant will have.
Right.
And also be able to continue the awesome breakfast and lunch that we had. You know, so we're gonna have, I'm not gonna say two restaurants in one, but you know, we need a really big fat souped up toaster to serve brunch,
sure.
right? Okay, no dinner restaurant needs a big toaster.
Right.
So we're trying to figure out where that's gonna go at night. And you know, and those logistics are ultimately really interesting to me and trying to think of ways that we can broaden our community and also give people more opportunities to visit us.
Right, and you're a restaurant, and as the breakfast place was, that likes to use a lot of local food, bring in to cook.
It's going to give us a platform to really help the Rhode Island food economy more than we did before, and spotlight people that are doing the right thing.
Which is great.
Yeah, it's really great.
It's nice to hear that you've combined your two paths. Like you said, you had the dinner experience, then you went to breakfast, and now you're It's a combination of everything, and you said you get to work with your brother.
I get to work with my brother, and I get to work
Is
with
Is that
all
a good thing?
It's a great thing.
That's good.
It's a wonderful thing, you know, and we're really trying to get, we have three nephews that live in Seattle, and so we are trying to woo them out for, like,
That's
summer
good.
Jobs
Come
to spend
on.
The summer in Rhode Island.
You anxious to get back
woo
in the game?
With
That's
the
right.
risotto.
I can't,
Very
can't
nice.
Wait.
Well, good. This is delicious.
This
we're
going
to keep digging in here, and if you want the recipe, head on over to WPRI.com.